And a thoughtful moment indeed. The national anthem and a crowd anxiously awaiting the tip-off. Two teams, two conferences. It's a road game for the Raptors in this one. You're in for a treat as we bring you NBA basketball on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg with Doris Burke reporting from the sidelines. Now we take a brief check at the matchups. Our starting five for both teams. And guys, what do you think we'll be seeing from Monte Ellis in this one?
Well, Ellis is one of the most acrobatic finishers in the NBA, Kevin. His ability to race in from the perimeter and score, either in transition or against a half-court defense. He finds his way to the rim, and he can finish once he gets there.
And he's shown the ability of absorbing contact, hanging, and still finishing. I think he could even stand to be more aggressive looking for contact, Steve, just to up those free throw attempts. But regardless, a devastating score around the rim. So often, teams that are near the bottom of the East tend to get drummed by the Western Conference teams, and that was the story last season for the Raptors. Had some close games and even a few upsets, but out West, they didn't fare very well.
And here are the Raptors now. Lowry dishes to Gay. Gay gets a screen from Valanciunas. Gay passes to Valanciunas. Gay against Marion. And DeRozan. Here we go. Lowry for three. That's good. Well, picking up that talk again on the Raptors, teams out West have so many great forwards to deal with that when you try and go up against them with a stretch four like the Raptors have had, it's going to be tough.
Yeah, particularly rebounding and defensively. Kevin, that's one of the reasons Toronto traded Bunyan to the Knicks in the offseason. They wanted to be a little better in terms of being physical and more punishing with their post players and having a better defensive presence.
And the basket by Johnson.
Fantastic pass. He turned that one into a pretty easy basket for his teammate.
Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Kevin, I had a chance to talk to head coach Rick Carlisle, and he said a big factor in this game will be how well they're able to handle Kyle Lowry. He admitted being a fan of his game, saying he's a tough athletic guard who really competes. Defense, rebounding, attack the paint, he'll take it to you. We've got to be ready to match his motor and his aggressiveness. Kevin, are they up to it?
All right, Doris. Here's Lowry after Dirk Nowitzki's bucket. Five to shoot. And DeRozan. Here we go. Soft touch off the glass.
Well, they just gave him 2 points. Defensively, you're going to have to tighten things up here. That's not a good sign.
We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. From deep, Ellis. Another three for Dallas.
Four straight shots to get this thing going.
The Raptors have gotten their first three shots to go in for to start off this game. Lowry gets a screen from Valanciunas. Gay drives in. Pass to Johnson. Count the bucket coming off a perfectly placed assist.
Great assist there. Led him to the perfect spot.
The Mavericks have gone 4-4 to start. So a nice offensive rhythm to start here.
Well, an interesting revelation regarding Rudy Gay came out recently. I mean, he's had vision issues for years and refused to wear corrective lenses, contacts, or goggles. That might explain why a player with such a great looking stroke would struggle with his shooting percentages from outside. Well, you know what? All good things must come to an end, and they finally miss after making their first four.
Near the three-point line, it's Ellis. That ball's nice speed this time from Jose Calderon.
They really look sharp here, razor sharp, extremely focused.
Here's Lowry, hits the target from 18 feet. Lowry's got 5 points so far. And Clark, you talked about Rudy Gay declining to wear contact lenses. Steve, that doesn't seem to make any sense to me.
Well, there's got to be a good reason for it. I haven't talked to Rudy about it. But look, I mean, every player has to be comfortable out on the floor. You either, you know, wear goggles or wear contacts or don't wear anything at all. I mean, it's, whatever is comfortable, that's the most important thing.
Now here's Gay. Dirk Nowitzki unable to get his shot to go. Gay kicks to Johnson. Gay dishes to DeRozan. Out of bounds, Dallas takes possession.
Boy, just a brain cramp, guys. I mean, that should have been the simplest of exchanges.
And it's the Mavericks with the ball. 3-point lead. Nowitzki with the screen on Lowry. Calderon passes to Nowitzki. Open shot by Marion, and it's Dallas with another.
Dirk Nowitzki, he can dish the rock, too.
The Raptors have gotten only one of their first six shots to fall today. Lowry with the ball. 5 points in the game. And then Johnson with the dunk.
You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod and then burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
No doubt, Clark. A pair of teammates with a terrific feel for each other out on the floor.
Mm-hmm. And what a play to make in a close game. A potential momentum builder.
Here's Ellis after the made shot from Johnson. Ellis kicks to Calderon. It's stolen by Lowry. Lays it in off the breakaway. Lowry's got 7 points.
These defenders look overmatched right now, especially inside.
Yeah, you look at the numbers. 10 of the last 12 points have come from close range, so I agree.
Calderon for three, and it's good. Assisting on the play was Nowitzki.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
And here's Lowry. He has 7. The drive by Gay. Back to Lowry. Launches a three. Shot is off. And it's Dallas the other way. Ellis dishes to Nowitzki. Back to Ellis. Here's the three. And again, good for Calderon for three. 6 points for him.
Well, they've settled into their offense very quickly here today.
Yeah, they're zoned in, making the most out of their possessions here.
So, timeout called here, the first for Toronto.
Well, I felt like his defense was letting him down out there, guys, so he wanted to get a timeout to talk it over and try to tighten things up here.
You know, part of coaching, a lot of coaching, actually, is making sure that momentum never gets too far away from your team. That's a good timeout.
A new group in now for the Raptors. Aaron Gray, he's checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Hansbrough's come in for Amir Johnson. Andrew Fields checking in for Rudy Gay. And it's Ross in for DeMar DeRozan. Here is Ross. He kicks it to Gray. Get it to go. And it's Dallas the other way.
And, you know, for Raptors coach Dwayne Casey from last season, he's wanted to improve the rim protection inside. Now with a little more size, you add Valanciunas, and hopefully the pieces are in place for Casey to build a winning team in Toronto.
Here's Augustine. After the made shot from Crowder, Augustine with it, picked up by Harris. To end the run, that's good from Augustine. The assist from Landry Fields.
Boy, this game is off to a terrific start.
No doubt. On both sides, high-octane offense.
And when you look at this Raptors team, they have size and athleticism, Steve, certainly capable of defending well.
Yeah, they do have the talent to be good defensively. Some length on the perimeter. They've got Amir Williams inside. And they've got Valanciunas is an interesting player with defensive capability. So this is a club that has the potential to be pretty good at that end of the floor.
And here's Hansbrough. Vince Carter getting it to go for Zeke. Here's Harris. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Here's Nowitzki, and it's Dallas with another.
This is outrageous. Every shot they're taking right now seems to be finding the mark.
Literally every shot. They are absolutely rolling.
Augustine from outside. Crowder pulls it in. Here's Harris. No shortage of scoring here at the end of the first quarter. The Mavericks on top as they end the second quarter with a 13-5 run. And we'll get going after this from the American Airlines Center. Well, not exactly a close game so far, but as the second quarter starts here, plenty of time for a comeback. And a chance for just a second now to check out the scoring breakdown for Dallas.
Well, I'll tell you what, they must have had a good shoot-around because they've been fantastic from long range so far, fellas.
And the other thing we're seeing is great ball movement. We're seeing a lot of good offensive execution, ball movement, player movement, setting up assists.
So on the floor for Toronto to start this second quarter. DJ Augustine out there with Terrence Ross. Then there's Tyler Hansbrough. And there's Landry Fields. And it's Gray at the center filling out the middle. Raptors trail by 11.
Anytime you see Vince Carter, and you start thinking about how he was as the undisputed dunk king in years gone by. But as his spring and lift has been grounded, he's made up for it in other ways and has really improved as a defender.
That is not enough coverage. Got to do better than that defensively. Basically, no coverage. I mean, defense did not look very good there.
Boy, they look helpless defensively.
And we're about a minute into the second quarter play. From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Burke.
Gentlemen, Rick Carlisle is widely considered an outstanding strategist and X and O's coach. But with the turnover on the Mavericks roster the last few seasons, he's tried to keep things as simple as possible for them. He said, quote, "My ongoing goal is to call less or no plays if we can. We want our guys to make plays." Kevin?
Well, Doris, when you've got that kind of talent and IQ, playing on instinct can certainly be effective. And Steve, going back to Carter, he really took the league by storm back with Toronto. Still an NBA player with great quality.
Yeah, he can do a little bit of everything, Kevin. Not the explosive guy that he once was, but he's always been a skill player with his long-range shooting, his ball handling, good passer. That's why he's still hanging around and still making a contribution here in the NBA.
And Toronto will go for a different look here. Jonas Valanciunas, he's checked in for Gray. Johnson comes in for Hansbrough. Rudy Gay's checked in for Landry Fields. And it's DeRozan in for Ross. Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played. Here's Valanciunas, and he drops it in from the low post.
The easiest way to do it sometimes is with the bounce pass.
Mavericks leading by 11. Oh! Here's the teardrop. And there's the bucket coming on the way up from Calderon. Calderon's got 8.
Guys, that time he went for the fancy finish for us there, man. That was sweet.
To the inside. It's tipped. It's stolen by Dallenberg. Ahead. Pull up Jay. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. 7 points for Vince Carter. Calderon against Lowry. Mar DeRozan on the wing. Gay outside. Just 5 to shoot. Johnson. That is good. He's got 8.
Boy, beautiful assist. That's a couple of teammates clearly on the same page.
Calderon against Lowry. Calderon kicks to Carter. Here's Dallenberg, and that one comes up a bit short. Raptors trail by 13. Here's DeRozan, and that one's good.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket, on time and on target. You know, the Mavs, like many teams, always aware of who the free agents are that might help them become better. And prior to last season, they made sure they got their finances in order to make a run at Deron Williams to bring him home to Texas. Didn't work out, but they did the same thing this last offseason.
And Dallas calls their first time out of the game. And for the Mavs, they know that in order for them to remain competitive and not go through a traditional rebuilding phase where they're going to finish, you know, at the bottom for a few years, you know, Steve, they're going to have to lure some free agents.
And one way or another, their top brass has always made sure that they would be able to move contracts around and make an offer to whatever big-name player was out there. But think about it. The last 2 years, they had unlimited cap room, unable to lure that big free agent fish. To
rising up and hammering it home. That could be just what they need to pick their energy up.
Wow, it definitely got the guys on the bench on their feet. I'll say that for man. Oh, man, was that fun.
Yeah, that will definitely pick up this team. He knew exactly what he was doing when he went for that slam.
And that was Kia bringing you the close-up on the big-time play.
I'm not sure that was the play they had set up, but it was too good a look to pass it.
Raptors trail by 14. Lowry kicks to Johnson. The pass to DeRozan. Shoots from the elbow. And another basket for Toronto.
Well, it looks like he's finally found his footing in this game. His first quarter was a real struggle, but he's gotten it going now.
Ellis goes in. Out to Carter. Yes, and it's Ellis picking up the assist. And it's 9 points for Vince Carter.
And that assist earned him a little nod from his teammate after the basket.
And the dunk by Valanciunas. I like that they're taking it inside and taking advantage of each opportunity, Clark, to chip away at the deficit.
Yeah, and doing it with the dunk is a major energizer, too. Gets the momentum going.
Yeah, and I think the interior defense, as good a job offensively as we saw, the defensive presence was almost non-existent. And they may see this lead disappear if they continue to give up those easy points.
And another gap in the defense found right there. This is one of the worst defensive performances I have ever seen.
Lowry with the ball. Now guarded by Calderon. .51 left to play here on the half. D'Alembert sets a screen for Ellis. Shot is off. And Toronto will come the other way.
You know, well, the days of the Matrix putting up 22 and 12 with a couple of steals every night are long gone. But Sean Marion is still a big factor for teams. He's such a solid defender with his reach and really causes problems in the passing lanes when he's out there acting.
And it's Ellis penetrating. And another shot. And the layup is good. Ellis has got 5 points in the quarter.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
Now here is Lowry. 9 points in the game so far. And again, Toronto with a triple. And at 35 years of age, Sean Marion still an outstanding rebounder, top five among small forwards and rebound rate last season.
And inside, he's very dangerous. He's got a lot of little funky shots, little floaters and runners. He does have the ability to step out and make a three, particularly from the corner, but it's really in the paint where he does his damage.
Maybe that'll ignite him. I mean, impossible not to get pumped up after that. At least I think that would be the case.
Well, you can see the immediate reaction of the guys on the bench. They are. Look at them. They are pumped up.
Yeah, they're geeked.
That's what those alley-oops do, though.
There's Ellis with the three ball. That one falls, coming off Carter's feet. 16 points for Ellis.
And fellas, in this quarter, he's improved on what was already a very good performance in period number one.
2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Lowry drives in. And another basket for Toronto.
Well, you know, he has shot the ball well, but it has not been contagious. And his teammates, they haven't had the same groove, and that's why we're looking at this result so far.
Calderon passes to D'Alembert. And Valanciunas with the block. So we've reached the end of the first half of play. Mavericks lead by 14. And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
I'm alongside Coach Casey. And, Coach, you guys are getting torched out there tonight. What's going on?
I don't know what has happened, but our defensive concentration, rotation has gone the way of the Buffalo. And I don't know what it is. I care less about offense. You know, we're going to score. That's not the problem. It's making up our mind and having a commitment to the defensive end.
Coach, thank you so much. Over to you guys.
Thanks, Doris. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter started.
And now, by Sprint.
Saturday, the best day of the week. Let's make it even a little bit better with a halftime show. For the Dallas Mavericks, they have the lead against Toronto. They've dialed in from long range, an incredible shooting performance from outside. Monte Ellis having a big-time game. His shooting percentage off the charts right now. He's got the magic touch from the field, no question about it. It's been a disappointment, though, for the Raptors so far. They've done a lackluster job boxing out for the defensive rebounds, getting run over inside. Through two quarters, Kyle Lowry in complete control. He's up to 14 points and is also helping set the table. Who's ready to eat? And that's all there is to it. Thanks so much for spending halftime with me. Now it's time to send you back out for the start of the third quarter.
The Sprint halftime report.
An impressive nighttime view of the American Airlines Center here in Dallas, Texas, as we return to NBA action. Monte Ellis has been sensational.
I know we've said this many times before, but I'll say it again. He had a great first half, just an explosive offensive display there.
At the end of the day, I wouldn't be surprised if we're talking about what a great second half he had. He can usually keep it going for all four quarters.
Well, we've got a moment. Let's set the floor. Brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up for the second half. On the floor for Dallas. Marion and Nowitzki at the fours. Ellis is out there with Calderon. And it's D'Alembert in at the five, roaming the paint. Johnson with a screen on Ellis. DeRozan's shot is good.
Well, that's one way to get your second half started on the right foot. An easy layup against some soft defense.
You know, it appeared to be another season where the Raptors would be near the bottom of the league, but while the terms rock bottom and embarrassing floated around, they made some moves and were able to go on a run to climb towards the middle of the pack.
That's exactly what they had in mind on that possession.
Calderon against Lowry. Kicks to DeRozan. Lock at six. Here's Gabe, and again it's Toronto converting. Well, we all know the trade for Rudy Gay, the major move coming last season for the Raptors. They were able to get a look at the playoff scenario at times. And, you know, Steve, it looked like they were much more competitive down the stretch.
Yeah, this is a team that has struggled the last 2 years. But I think that spark near the end of the regular season gives them hope. And now it's time to start that climb, get back into the playoffs, and continue to build and become an excellent NBA franchise because they have the potential to do so.
Toronto calls timeout. They have to like what we're seeing from Monte Ellis.
He's been locked in from deep. They're giving him too much breathing room and definitely paying the price for it.
All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Kevin, over that last break, I got a chance to hear what Rick Carlisle said to his team. He told the huddle they need to go hard to the hoop whenever possible to either draw fouls or get high percentage right at the 10. There's still plenty of basketball left to play, and as we watch how these adjustments play out, Kev, it'll be interesting.
Thank you, Doris. Mavericks leading by 15. Dallas calls timeout.
You know, you got to love the way that Amir Johnson attacks around the rim, whether it's, you know, looking to finish off a play or grab a rebound or block a shot. You love his no-nonsense approach to defending and finishing in the lane.
Marion dishes to Nowitzki, uses the glass to finish the layup. Nowitzki's got eight. And Amir Johnson, not just a finisher, Clark around the rim. Shot blocker, pretty good defender.
Yeah, he's got excellent length for a power forward, and he's put some rocks in his pockets over the years. He's become better able to hold his ground inside. Folks, that means basically he's added some weight, is what's happened with Amir.
Dallas leading by 17. Now Ellis, he's got 21. He feeds it to Calderon. Yes, and it's Ellis picking up the assist. Ellis has got his fourth assist in this one.
And the threes continue to go down at that end with almost nothing happening from deep at the other.
But the way to turn that around is defensively, by stopping their outside shot, not by getting into a shootout.
Here's Valanciunas, and he gets the bucket. Valanciunas has got six.
And still perfect here in the second half. 4 for 4 from the field.
Calderon against Lowry. And D'Alembert kicks to Ellis. Ellis off a pick from Nowitzki. The drive by Ellis. Shot from 12. And another basket for Dallas.
And they've really come out of halftime with the eye of the tiger. Plenty of fire in their eyes and tremendous focus and intensity.
Lowry passes to Gay. And there's the feed to Johnson. Here's DeRozan. And he gets the bucket. He's got 14.
I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
I agree. They need more energy in the post. Maybe some double teaming. They've got to get their defense in gear.
Ellis dishes to Nowitzki. That's good. Nowitzki's got 10 points.
And they've set up countless buckets off assists. That's a huge part of what they've been doing here today. A
lot of dime dropping going on out there, Steve.
Lowry with the ball. Now guarded by Calderon. And DeRozan. Here we go. And the layup's good off the glass.
What an excellent performance from the field for him.
Mavericks leading by 18. Calderon kicks to Ellis. That falls. Nice feed this time from Jose Calderon. And now it's up to 25 points for Ellis. To the inside. Hayes. Down it goes. Jamming that one home. Putting on a show for these people.
I cannot believe he pulled that one out in the course of an actual game. Are you kidding me?
Oh, man. Might as well flaunt it if you got it, Clark.
This last summer, the Mavs asked fans to submit some redesigns of their uniforms for future use. Always kind of neat to see when a team and organization reaches out for the fans' input.
The more touches he gets, the more this lead will grow. He has just been unconscious this quarter.
Johnson, good.
Now, he's one of the best in the league when it comes to executing that lead pass.
Dallas has gotten the three ball working for them in the second half. They've hit three out of three shots from long range. And back to the Mavs. Definitely a big move by them to reach out like that. Nothing like bringing crowdsourcing to the NBA and building a bridge, you know, Steve, with your fan base.
You know, Kevin, I had a chance to see some of the designs of the uniforms that were being suggested. Some pretty sharp looking duds, but there were some other ones that were absolutely hideous. So let's hope the decision makers in the Mavs organization pick some of the, let's say, the more clean looking uniform suggestions.
There's the bucket. Good. 30 points for Ellis.
His work at the offensive end has been phenomenal. Maybe reason number one, they're ahead.
And the Raptors call time here.
Well, Monte Ellis has never been short on confidence, and last year he went as far as comparing himself to Dwayne Wade, saying the only difference between them is that Wade has rings. That's a pretty big difference, though.
A new group in now for the Raptors. Aaron Gray, he's checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Hansbrough comes in for Amir Johnson. Landry Fields checking in for Rudy Gay. And it's Ross in for DeMar DeRozan. Here's Ross. Releases from the wing and drills it. And you talk about the talent and confidence for Monte Ellis. Steve, what's the balance between confidence and like overconfidence?
Well, I think the balance is in your decision-making, and that's the trickiest thing for really talented young players to figure out. It's just when to attack and when to back off a little bit. And that's all stuff that just comes with experience.
Augustine passes to Ross. To the paint. Here's Gray, and he uses the glass on the layup.
Look at the points in the paint, the inside game. It's been very one-sided here for a while now.
Well, the defense just hasn't been physical enough at the rim. I mean, 8 of their last 10 points have come from the paint.
Raptors trail by 15. And Augustine kicks to Ross, out to the wing. Hansbrough dishes to Gray. That drops. Gray's got 6.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Now, you got to make a defensive adjustment here, Clark. Time to collapse inside, force the ball back out on the perimeter, make them beat you from long range.
They just continue to splash home those threes. Eliminating the deep shot has to become priority number one for this defense.
It really does. I mean, it's not possible to give up that many points behind the arc and not pay the price in the end.
That's good.
And, yeah, they're moving the ball now. 8 of their last 10 points coming off assisted buckets.
Steve, nothing makes a coach smile as much as pure, selfless teamwork.
And here's Augustine. He's got 6. 2 on the clock, and it's good on the way in. Augustine's got 8 points.
I'll tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Mavericks ahead. They lead by 14. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get started for the fourth quarter. Raptors trail by 14. On the court for Toronto to start the fourth. We've got Landry Fields, Gray out there with Tyler Hansbrough. Then it's Terrence Ross, and it's Augustine in at the point. Here's Hansbrough out of bounds. Dallas takes possession. Amir Johnson's checked in for Aaron Gray. Dallas leading by 14. Harris Pass inside. Now recovering. It's stolen by Hansbrough. Here's DeRozan. And that one is hammered home.
Yeah, nice fast break from start to finish, guys.
Especially on the back end. I mean, he polished it off perfectly.
Here is Harris. Passes to Crowder. It is now to Carter. And he gets it to go from the corner. And the Mavericks lead by 14.
Good ball movement. He put that pass in the ideal spot, right where it needed to be.
Lowry gets to DeRozan. We played just over 1 minute here in the fourth quarter. Sinks that one from the post.
Well, he's a really difficult cover because if he gets anywhere near the rim, he can finish. Great strength, the ability to convert in the lane. Boy, that's tough to defend.
And applies even if he has to absorb contact getting to the rim.
There's the triple. It's hauled in by the Raptors. Johnson, the pass to Gay. The shot's good on the assist by Johnson. And that's now 6 points for Rudy Gay.
Well, their plan of attack has been pretty clear to see. You get the ball inside and just take it strong to the hoop. Be dominant in the lane.
Well, the defense has been very slow to adjust. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
There's the bucket. Good.
Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
Lowry with the ball. Picked up by Harris. Gay outside. Johnson down low. Harder on him. Gets it down to single digits. And that's now 17 points for Kyle Lowry.
Yeah, he's been the key cog in their offense with the way he shot the ball.
His percentage today, beyond impressive. Certainly not his fault to score is what it is.
You know, they've been able to depend on his offense all game long, guys. He's drained a lot of shots out here.
And between now and the horn, Steve, the ball should be in his hands as much as possible if they want to continue to build this lead.
Out of bounds, Dallas will take possession. A new group in now for the Raptors. Here's Ellis. D'Alembert sets a screen for Ellis. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in. Ellis has got 18 points just in the second half. Raptors trail by 13. Rudy Gay on the wing.
Oh, man, that was unreal.
Mark it up. Even when they're down, he's still looking to do the spectacular. And he pulled it off.
Well, maybe this is the best time to do it.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, now's when they need a little spark anyway.
Ellis goes in. Solid play on the low block, and that one's good. Ellis has got 6 in the quarter.
He has really shot the ball extremely well, as you'd expect. Like we say, he's been making sweet string music all day long.
Dallas leading by 13. Dishes it to Calderon. Pass to D'Alembert. Nowitzki inside. And that one's good.
Don't take your eyes off of him because he can make plays from multiple spots on the floor. Put the isolated cam on him.
Lowry kicks to Gay. Valanciunas with the ball. Now guarded by D'Alembert. Rosen dishes to Lowry. DeRozan a screen on Calder. Just 4 to shoot. The drive by Lowry. Here's Valanciunas. And terrific work on the offensive glass, and he picks up 2.
Boy, where was the box out? Too easy on that second chance opportunity.
Yeah, no box out is what happened there. Those kind of mistakes on the glass will kill a team.
Calderon with it. Lowry picks him up. Calderon passes to Marion. Goes back up. And it's out of bounds to the Mavericks as Dallas retains possession. And so here is Dallas. Their biggest lead of the game was 21. Calderon kicks to Nowitzki. feeds to Ellis. Shot clock at 6. They double-team Ellis. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. Toronto calls timeout. They're down by 13. We've got 1:55 left in the fourth quarter. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Yes, Kevin. Dwayne Casey was just going over the plan with his team. He said their offense has been a little too sluggish for his liking, saying, quote, take what the defense gives you. Don't hesitate to let those shots fly. He also wants them to play very physically. Impose your will on them, he said. Let them know who they're up against. With the minutes ticking down and the deficit still a big one, those adjustments have to be a chance worth taking, Kevin.
Always great to hear from you, Doris. DeRozan's shot is good.
Looked like there was a little confusion there as to who was supposed to be guarding him.
And the Mavericks call time here. They're ahead by 10. A minute 42 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Kevin, I was able to listen in on what Rick Carlisle was going over with his team in that last huddle. He told the players, let's put our foot on them and keep them down. We've got them exactly where we want them. I want to see you guys slow the pace, use the clock, and stay away from any silly fouls.
The drive by Ellis. And it's Kyle Lowry with the rebound.
And that's a shot he had to take.
For sure, it was a good decision, just poor execution.
He dishes it to Gay. Good on the shot, and that shaves the lead to single digits.
One of the reasons they're behind is because we haven't seen enough of that. He needs to become a bigger part of the offense.
Lowry against Calderon. He's looking for down there and finds him. Takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
A little bit of a magic act here, pulling off for Houdini to make that catch and slam.
Stupendous, stupendous alley-oop.
Ooh, this crowd just stunned at the sight of that one.
Oh, and there's the alley-oop. And the dunk by DeRozan. Calderon with it. He kicks it to Dallenberg. That ball's nice speed this time from Jose Calderon.
And at this point, just sort of running through the paces, going through the motions, as it appears. It'll be a nice win here for the Mavericks.
And the big difference here was accuracy behind the three-point line, Clark.
Well, they started spraying them from deep, and then it spread out the defense, and they had all the looks they wanted.
And you have to look back at this and see what a huge gain it's been for Ellis. He was extremely efficient offensively, getting looks, knocking down big shots all game long.
Lowry drives in, and the shot is good.
Now, when he gets an opening like that, he'll definitely take it.
There's 42 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Ellis outside. Pass to Calderon. Back to Ellis.
He defended the shot, got back in the play, and grabbed the board. Nice play.
Connects! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket. On time and on target.
And now we've got the intentional foul. Seventeen seconds left to play here in the fourth, and so they foul intentionally. Drops the first one, and that increases their lead to 6. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a 7-point game.
The free throws go down, and the lead goes up.
Toronto calls timeout. They're behind by 7. 15 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. What's your take, guys?
Well, this one's out of reach, so I'm not sure why they're calling the timeout here. Maybe just to try to work on something, maybe an out-of-bounds play or something.
Well, they might as well talk about what movies they want to see or what they want to surf on the internet, because this one's done, boys.
15 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Three-pointer Augustine. Good! And now they trail by just four. Here is Harris. And they foul intentionally. That's what they have to do at this point.
Yeah, no question, the right call at this point. You can't let them just dribble it out.
That's right. I mean, you've got to send them to the line and hope for a few misses.
So the first one drops, and that puts them up by five. The Raptors making a switch here. So he goes two for two at the line, and it's a six-point ball game.
And that ought to do it. Any chance for a miracle comeback just went out the window with those free throws.
Frames it from downtown.
He had his head on the swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
Dallas calls timeout. They're up by three. 3 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Intentional foul. He hits the first one, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. Second free throw, no good that time. He really wanted that one. So it's a narrow victory for the Mavericks, pulling out the W. Well, they don't get much more exciting than that, Clark.
They sure don't. And when it was gut check time, this team kept their composure, kept their emotions in check, and got it done.
And now let's go over to Doris Burke.